Before we begin to shape the Equiskin horseback saddle stand, to replicate your horse's back shape, we will need to gather some tools. We will need the horseback saddle stand, or here at Schleza, more fondly known as Sapphire, the saddle fit matrix. We will need a leather wither tracer, a springer gauge, a ruler, some pens, a Schleza saddle fit evaluation form, an arc device, your filled out long distance fit kit measurements, and lastly, your shoulder and top line tracing cutouts. Once we have all the required tools, we first use some levels to ensure that the device is level front to back as well as from left to right. This allows us to accurately shape Sapphire to replicate your horse's back. Next, we will take the over-the-shoulder tracing cutout and place it on Sapphire. We then manipulate the beads within the device to match the shape of your tracing. One of the reasons it's so important to ensure that your horse is standing square and is measured on level ground is to ensure that the tracings are accurate to your horse's shape. By ensuring that your horse is square when measuring and tracing, it allows us to properly rebuild your horse's back shape for an accurate fitting. Once the over-the-shoulder tracing is flush with the device, we then take the behind-the-shoulder tracing and place it 4 inches behind the first cutout. We can then begin shaping Sapphire to mimic the shape of your horse's shoulder. We manipulate the beads within the device to shape the shoulder until both the tracings are flush against the device. After shaping, Sapphire will provide us with a 3D visual of your horse's shoulder over the widest part as well as directly behind the scapula when both tracings are flush on the device. Once we are satisfied with the shoulder shape, we refer to the protractor measurements you have taken on lines 1 and 2 and confirm the angle on Sapphire. If the angle is not the same, we continue to shape the device until they match. Next, we take your top line cutout and cut 2 slits where line 1 and 2 are on the cutout for the other tracings. Then, we place the top line cutout on top of the other 2 cutouts already on Sapphire and begin forming the device to match your horse's top line. Once the top line cutout is flush with the device, we have finished replicating your horse's back shape with Sapphire. Our next step is to begin filling out the Schleza evaluation form for record keeping, so both you and your certified saddle ergonomist can track the changes in your horse and will include our calculation conversions for our in-house fitting tools. The first step is to trace your shoulder cutouts onto your form. First, we line up the center lines on your cutouts with the center lines on our evaluation form to make sure that we do not skew the horse's shape and to ensure that any asymmetry is identified. Using this square tool, we line up the top of the tool to the line you drew under your phone when your protractor was level. Then, we adjust the tracing so that the side of the tool lines up with the center line of the evaluation form. This ensures that when tracing, the cutouts reflect your horse's shape as accurately as possible and can exemplify any asymmetry. We then trace the inside of both your cutouts onto the form. Next, we take our LWT tool, as used by our certified saddle ergonomists on site, to identify where the points of the cross-section of the trapezius and latissimus muscles are on the horse. These reference points are necessary for when our in-house fitters are adjusting the tree of the saddle. Referring back to the protractor measurements we confirmed when shaping the device, we then take our springer gauge and calculate the equivalent degree on our tool to identify the shoulder angle of your horse using our springer gauge. Then, we take our ruler and place it on the larger shoulder tracing on the evaluation form to confirm your horse's shoulder angle. Next, we place the springer gauge on the tracing and confirm the shoulder angle by ensuring that the ruler and the arm of the springer are parallel with our pen. This measurement gets written on the evaluation form so our in-house fitters know what the horse's shoulder angle is and to ensure it is accommodated for when fitting the gullet plate of the saddle. Next, we refer to the protractor measurements you took from lines 3 to 6 and begin adjusting the arc device to match the angles. We do this by taking a phone with the protractor app similar to what you would have used and placing it where the measurements should have been taken on lines 3 to 6 on the horse, and begin adjusting the arms of the device to match. We then confirm the top line measurement to ensure it matches the protractor measurement you took between lines 3 and 4. Once the top line has been set, we confirm the arms of the device by ensuring that the angle as per the protractor measurements you took are the same. Once the arms and top line have been set, we make sure the arc device is level using the small level on the back of the device. After the arc device has been set and is level, we begin marking down the converted arc device numbers on the evaluation form for fitting the saddle, as well as for record keeping so you and your certified saddle ergonomist can track changes in your horse's top line. At this point, this is what your certified saddle ergonomist has been able to fill out on the evaluation form. All the information you provide us is necessary to ensure that the saddle you purchase from us or get refit by us is adjusted to your horse's exact measurements and conformational factors similar to the information you would gather during a professional on-site evaluation. Schlaese Saddlery is the industry leader in proper saddle fit and saddle manufacturing. Now, with our online saddle fit evaluation and assessment service, we can assist you both on-site and online to ensure proper saddle fit for both you and your horse. If you have any questions regarding the information in this video, please contact us using the following contact information to be connected with the Schlaese representative.